Goedemiddag. Good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon.
People are saying good afternoon. Remember, this is a happy occasion, so smile. Before I formally constitute this ceremony, I'd like to use the opportunity to salute our graduates for just making it this far, particularly given the fact that most of you had a very difficult journey to travel. I think you're all aware of the fact that at the end of last year, the higher education sector throughout the country experienced tremendous challenges. And many of you had to write your exams under extremely difficult conditions. So we acknowledge that, and we commend you for your resilience, for the perseverance that you've shown. And we're just happy to have you all here today so that we can celebrate the special occasion with you here. So thank you for that. By the powers vested in me, I hereby formally constitute this gathering of the Cape Peninsula University of Technology. You may be seated.
Molweni. Goeiemiddag, dames en here. Good afternoon, everyone. Before we begin the ceremony, can we join together in a moment of silence for prayer and meditation, please? I thank you. Deputy Vice Chancellor, Professor Anthony Stark, who is presiding over the ceremony as a chancellor, members of council who are here, distinguished guests, particularly our guest speaker, Mr. Niresh Suful, members of staff, parents, friends, guardians, and most important of all, our graduates. SRC President, Mr. Twala, also acknowledged. Good afternoon, and welcome to this joyous occasion where we celebrate the achievement of all those who will be graduating here today. This is a very special day for all of you, representing the culmination of years of study, hard work, and sacrifice. Sacrifices not only on the part of you, the graduates, but also of parents, of partners, and family members and networks who provided financial and moral support throughout your period of study. So this ceremony represents a celebration of a collective efforts of all who contributed to your achievements. This year, we will be awarding 6,806 diplomas and degrees in 15 graduation ceremonies taking place throughout this week on our Belleville campus. At these ceremonies, we will be awarding 74 master's degrees and 12 doctoral degrees. Today, we will be conferring qualifications and on candidates in the Faculty of Business and Management Sciences, by far the largest faculty in the institution. 5 graduation ceremonies are devoted entirely to this faculty. This faculty has established strong partnership both locally and internationally with a number of networks. It's currently run a vibrant student staff exchange program with a number of internationally renowned universities. The faculty has made significant progress in promoting a research agenda over the past few years, and has recently been awarded 2 research chairs, one of which is funded by the wholesale and research retail sector. the other by the EDTP sitter. The faculty has furthermore established a center for tourism research in Africa and is developing further research niche area in sports management and public management. The Cape Peninsula University of Technology is currently the largest university in the Western Cape with over 3,000 students, including a strong contingent of international students representing more than 70 countries across the globe. We are regarded as a leading university of technology, having increased our research outputs to a point where it exceeds that of a number of traditional universities. We are currently embarking on a major infrastructure development program to support further growth at both the undergraduate and the postgraduate levels. And we have the intention of consolidating our academic department on particular campuses of CPUT. We have recently completed 7 major building projects for electrical engineering, health sciences, horticulture, and South African Renewable Energy Technology Center, which is referred to as SARATEC for short, on the Bellville campus. We also have teacher education in Wellington and Mowbray, as well as agriculture in Wellington, and a new residence in Cape Town. Eventually, we hope to consolidate our science, engineering, and technology, or SET programs, on the Bellville campus, and our business, ICT, and design program on the Cape Town campus. Our vision is to be at the heart of technology education and innovation in Africa. And we believe that through technology and innovation, we will be able to address critical issues relating to economic and social development, both in this region and nationally. As alumni of this institution, we hope that you will also commit to this vision. Many of you will go on to occupy influential positions in commerce, in industry, and in public sector, but we sincerely hope that you will not forget the communities from which you come. We hope that you will use your special skills and your influence to put something back into those communities and to help contribute to their development. Together, we hope that you will help us realize our goal of creating futures, not only for our students, but for the broader society as well. We hope that you will continue to support this institution and that your future professional development will take place here. With the rapid pace of change and the globalization of knowledge, it will become imperative that you continue to upgrade your knowledge and skill on a regular basis. And we hope that we at the Cape Peninsula University of Technology will have a role to play in your lifelong learning. We know that our alumni are our greatest ambassadors. That is why your success is so important to us. We are proud of what you have achieved thus far and sincerely hope that we have helped to place you on a trajectory that will lead you to even greater success in the future. Congratulations once again on your fine achievements. We salute you as graduates of the Cape Peninsula University of Technology and wish you continued success and everything of the best in your future. I thank you. Deputy Vice Chancellor, it is now a great pleasure for me to introduce our guest speaker this afternoon, Mr. Nivesh Suful. Nivesh Suful is the CEO of African Ideas, a strategic consultancy that he founded focusing on helping government to accelerate the benefit of ICT-enabled change through transformation of public sector and the wider economy. Nivesh has more than 25 years of experience in the ICT industry and has been involved in many large, complex, and innovative, and often controversial projects. Nivesh is well regarded as a thought leader within the ICT industry in South Africa and internationally. He has been an expert speaker at many local and global conferences, as well as contributing to numerous paper and research initiatives. He is known as being a visionary, dynamic leader with extensive experience at executive and strategic management level. However, in addition to vision and strategy, he has an excellent track record of successfully delivering large, complex projects cutting across multiple departments and operational units, ensuring that the business benefit is achieved, essentially turning vision into strategic reality. His work experience, mainly related to ICT-enabled business transformations, spans a diverse set of large, complex organizations. Nivesh and his project have won several local international awards. For example, the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation Access to Learning, which was awarded in Berlin, the 21st Century Achievement Award from the Computer World Honors Program, that was actually awarded in Washington, D.C., the African ICT Achievers Award, Computer Society IT Personality of the Year, the Chief Information Officer or CIO of the Year, and the Western Cape Premier's Provincial Honors Award. Nivesh is passionate about the potential of ICT and digital solutions to transform societies, culture, and economics, especially in developing countries. He believes that digital technology used effectively can be incredibly powerful positive force for African development. A key aspect of his current work revolves around understanding trends relating to digitization, big data, mobile, social media, cloud, digitization inclusion, open data, broadband, etc., and their impact on government, citizens, and the economy. Nivesh has a BSc with majors in computer science and mathematics, a BCom honors in information systems, and an MBA from the University of Cape Town Graduate School. He is also a member of several professional bodies. He lives in Cape Town with his wife and two children. Deputy Vice Chancellor, it is now my greatest pleasure to call on Ms. Nivesh Sufool to deliver his keynote.
Vice Chancellor, members of the Council, members of the Executive Management of CPUT, Deans of Faculties, academic and administrative staff of CPUT, distinguished guests, families and friends of the graduates, and most importantly, the graduates themselves. Thank you for inviting me to this event. I'm honored to be here with you. As was mentioned in the introduction, I run a company called African Ideas, which is a strategy and innovation company focused on Africa. Our services focus on strategic planning, research, and disruptive innovation, especially related to the impact of digitization across society. We collaborate with companies and governments to devise transformative growth strategies, build innovation capabilities, and create products, services, and solutions that improve people's lives. Our name embodies the principles that we believe in and strive towards: African innovation, African development, African empowerment, African action, and African solutions. We believe in the ripple effect. So we believe that dropping a stone or even a drop of water in a pond causes ripples to emanate from the source, getting bigger and bigger away from the source as they get. We believe that this is a powerful example of how small changes can cause large and far-reaching effects. At African Ideas, we specialize in working with our clients to identify these big lever projects. Those projects which, when embarked upon, will set in place the necessary ripples to drive change and transformation throughout the ecosystem. In that way, we aim to have a profound effect on the society in which we operate. Some people call this the butterfly effect also. But it's important to understand how you as individuals can actually affect the society that you actually operate in. A few years ago, I was invited to do a similar talk like this one. And in that talk, I spoke about a very interesting MIT Technology Review article that I was trying to get my head around. The article was titled, How Technology is Destroying Jobs. And it was clearly of interest to me because I had always held the view that technology can have a massive impact on social and economic development of a country. So this concerned me, actually, because we always say that technology can grow the economy, it can create jobs, it can do all of those kind of things. And I was starting to wonder if some of the Luddites that we seem to have in charge of our country might actually have it right after all, and if I was the one that actually had it wrong. The article was about how automation is eliminating the need for people in many jobs and was based on US data. What it showed was that historically, economic growth and jobs numbers closely matched one another. However, from the early 2000s, this pattern started to diverge, with economic growth outstripping job creation. Essentially, what that meant was that the economy was growing, but that it wasn't actually creating as many jobs as it used to. And the authors of the study argued that this was because of technological advances. The rapid acceleration of technology progress, they say, has greatly widened the gap between economic winners and losers. Digital technology tends to favor superstars, they point out. So for an example, someone who creates a computer program to automate tax preparation might earn millions of dollars while eliminating the need for countless accountants. So the MIT review article does present both sides of the argument, and it actually does counter this view. But the most important thing is that the article does conclude with a very interesting quote, where it states that it is one of the dirty secrets of economics. Technology progress does grow an economy and does create wealth, but there is no economic law that says that everyone will benefit. And I think it's important for people to understand this. As we go forward, we'll talk a little bit about that. In other words, what they are saying is that in the race against the machine, some are likely to win while others may lose. And in fact, this was the subject of great discussion at the Davos conference earlier this year, where world leaders were starting to look at the things like the impact of robotics and all of those issues on the world economies, on the issues of the future of work and all of those issues. You are graduating from a technology university, so it's important to understand basically where the world is actually moving in terms of this. So why am I telling you this? Because it's important that you understand that the world is changing, right? Jobs that exist today will not exist in a few years' time. And education is important, but it is not enough. What you need to do is you need to take what you've learned in the books and you need to make it your own. You need to find new ways to solve problems. If you do things the way everyone else is doing things, or in the way everyone else has actually done it, then you are one of the followers. And you are one of the million people that can do the same things because you have the same education. If you want success, you need to try to think of new ways of solving old problems. Very often we look at things and we say, I can make it better. And that's great, that's innovation. But sometimes we look at things and say, I could do something entirely different that would make the lives easier for people. And that's invention. So Uber is the world's largest taxi company, and it owns no vehicles. Facebook is the world's most popular media owner, and it creates no content. Alibaba is the world's most valuable retailer, and it has no inventory. And Airbnb, which is the world's largest accommodation provider, owns no real estate. These businesses have been created from understanding what people need and have not tried to improve on what was out there, but have rather created entirely new ways of meeting the need. And it's as important to understand this thing on this focus on invention. When we did the ERP, which is an integrated system essentially in the city of Cape Town, many people told us that it could not be done, that it would be a colossal failure, that it had never been done anywhere else in the world like this, etc. One person described it as trying to change both engines on a Boeing while the Boeing was still flying, obviously implying that we were going to crash and burn like the Boeing. But we did succeed, and it was a huge success. We achieved national and international acclaim with many awards. the most notable of which was the Computer World Honors Award in Washington, D.C. in 2005. Interestingly enough, in 2004, so the year before we achieved that award in 2005, Apple Computers won an award at the same event the previous year. They won an award for shaping the global music industry through the introduction of its iPod and the iTunes Music Store. Now, some of you might not know what an iPod is because nowadays you have phones and you have iPhones and all of those things. But essentially, it was the precursor to that, and it changed the way digital music is consumed in the world. When we did SmartCape, which provided free public internet to 100 libraries in Cape Town, our critics again said it wouldn't work. They said that people would not use it, that the technology that we were using, which was open source technology, would be too hard, that we hadn't planned properly, that we didn't have the stack of data and research that would back up what we were trying to do. And yet it did work. We rolled out 500 computers to 100 libraries across the whole of Cape Town in less than a year. It was the largest free internet project of its kind on the African continent. We also won the prestigious Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation Access to Learning Award in Berlin for that project, with a prize of $1 million for the city. 13 years later, the SmartCape facilities are part of the fabric of the City of Cape Town libraries. There are in excess of 500,000 registered users of these facilities, and the city cannot meet the demand for more facilities. In the age of tablets and smartphones, free Wi-Fi is now being rolled out into the libraries. These projects are the drop that I spoke about. They were the start of a process that recognized that technology could be used as a key enabler to change the way the City of Cape Town delivered its services and engaged its citizens. Because of this and many other innovative projects, Cape Town was the first African city to be listed as one of the top 21 intelligent communities of the world, and is today recognized as a global leader and reference in the use of technology for municipal service delivery. African ideas also developed and drove the implementation of the Western Cape broadband strategy. Again, around 2000, when we were developing the strategy, people said that it would never happen. When we mooted the idea of a schools wide area network, a high-speed broadband network interconnecting all of the schools in the province, which is a radical change to the way schools are connected in the province, people told us that we were crazy. People inside government and outside government said this would never happen. It would be too expensive, etc. They said that if it happened, it would only benefit schools in the urban areas and would not touch the rural areas. The reality is that this infrastructure is currently being deployed across the province, both in the urban and rural area. About 50% of the schools in this province are already done, and the rest will happen by the end of this year. Approximately 2,000 government facilities, government offices, schools, libraries, hospitals, clinics, community centers, etc., are being connected to this high-speed broadband network. This infrastructure is being deployed at a cost that is one-third of what the national government departments were saying it would cost to deploy. They said that it would cost about 9 billion rand, but we are actually getting it for about 3 billion rand. More importantly, it is being built with private sector funding, and government is only paying for the services that it uses at a cost that is cheaper than what it is currently paying for the services. This is an example of the type of thinking that I was talking about, where using a completely different approach can solve a problem that we did not think we had a solution to. When we spoke about public Wi-Fi, people said that it would not work, that it was discredited technology. They argued that poor people did not have appropriate devices. They questioned why we wanted to focus on poor areas and not richer areas where there was demand, all of those issues. We did not let that negativity stop us. The reality is that this level of cheap mass communication is what is needed if we want to take this country forward. We need solutions that work for poor people, for people that will live in shacks with tin roofs. We felt that the fact that this had not been done elsewhere should not stop us. Today, public Wi-Fi is being deployed widely all over the country, both by government and the private sector. Companies have deployed technologies like Wi-Fi calling, video on demand, TV stations, various education solutions, etc., on top of these public Wi-Fi platforms. The beneficiaries of these projects are largely poor communities. Earlier in my career, I adopted the philosophy of think globally and act locally. In those days, a lot of friends and colleagues were leaving South Africa because the world had opened up and there were so many opportunities to do interesting projects around the world, especially in the field of technology. I wanted to stay and make a difference to South Africa. I felt that my skills and passion could make a real difference to the country. However, I was concerned about stagnation. I felt that if I was here, maybe I'm not getting exposure to the same kind of projects that we have at the global level. That is when a group of us came up with this think globally, act locally philosophy. We vowed that we will always aim to think globally and be the best at what we did in a global context, but that we would execute locally out of choice. In other words, we would choose to operate in South Africa and in Africa. This is something that I always try to get my staff and my children to understand and to buy in. If you are doing something, do it well. Try to be better than anyone else in the world at what you do. And then you can actually choose where you want to use your talents. In summary, change is certain. Embrace it and understand how you are going to change with it. Education is very important, and you have reached a key milestone with regards to this. However, a commitment to lifelong learning is needed. You can never know all that there is to know, especially as things are changing at such a rapid pace. I am still learning things on a daily basis, and I love it. We live in an exciting continent. Africa is a place where everyone wants to be, and it is teeming with opportunities. People are coming from the rest of the world to operate in Africa. But it is also the place that we call home, so we must embrace it. However, more of the same is not going to work. We have to think of new, innovative ways of solving the complex problems that face us. We have to root these solutions in our own context. We have to create African solutions for Africa's problems. The future is bright. Congratulations on your achievement and good luck for the future.
I have often dreamed of a far-off place where a hero's welcome would be waiting for me, where the crowds would cheer when they see my face, and a voice keeps saying, "This is where I'm meant to be. I'll be there someday. I can go the distance. I will find my way. If I can be strong, I know every mile will be worth my while. When I go the distance, I'll be my fate. Though that road may wander, it will lead me to you. And 1,000 years will be worth the wait. It might take a lifetime, but somehow I'll see it through. And I won't look back. I will go. But I won't lose hope till I go the distance and my journey is complete. But to see beyond the glory is the hardest part, for a hero's strength is measured by his heart.
Vice Chancellor, I request you to confer diplomas and degrees within the Faculty of Business and Management Sciences on the following candidates.
By the authority vested in me, the certificates, diplomas, and degrees will be awarded to the candidates as presented to me.
National Diploma, Cost and Management Accounting, Shantae Lee Abrams. Megan Deirdre Abrams. Jessica Ayo Adyoke Akboten. Selma Tukaleni Ambilu. Clu Bam. Lona Piwe Sisanda Bam. Zanele Lucretia Bam. Houston Taswell Basson. Sibongiseni Bele. Leslie Ann Gaby Birkes, cum laude. Ladies and gentlemen, the criteria for cum laude are as follows. A candidate should have passed all the subjects of the qualifications at the first attempt. Secondly, the candidate should have obtained an average of 75% in all the courses of the qualification. And thirdly, should have obtained an average of 75% in the final level courses. Roxanne Ursula Beyers. Sisamkele Sengani. Carly Albert Shabane. Florence Marlene Kluter. The following diploma is awarded posthumous. I'm calling upon the parent of Luvuyo Milali Koko to come to the stage, please. Thank you, sir. Luvuyo Milali Koko. Shania Davids. Geraldine Drachunder. Setembeso Kumka. Nomfundu Trepino Kweya. Sandiswa Gwele. Lauren Karen Hendricks. Patishwa Jejani. Sipukazi Julosa. Yongama Juta. Lisu Lomzi Mbulela Kaingana. Siavuya Kechingana. Sandrine Renee Kibango. Melanie Candice Koopman. Emmanuel Moji Letulu. Luku Magadla. Sandy Siwe Mankuza. Linda Mbetu. Samantha Mbunji. Ntombizanele Menyane. Zolisa Vincent Nketu. Luyanda Mlanyeni. Isetu Enoch Nchansa. Melissa Janice Mocha. Marwan Musa. Amanda Morgan. Bronwyn Elizabeth Mori. Kambala Mugoy Moody. Kabengele Alpha Mukuna. Ntandukazi Nase. Sinuvuyo Dadlana. Bulelwa Bubliner Nkumbozi. Boyeshwa Anita Ngwendu. Matabu Njadu. Zitu Nuhuza. Asipe Nkunkwa. Lizanne Abigail Oliver. Brandel Malcolm Peters. Zikona Poli. Kanyisa Screech. Sinatoro Siguela. Nomzamu Veronica Smal. Samantha Lillian Tice. Fabrice Chibangu. Duran Godley van Rienen, cum laude. Rebecca Kabena Sipamba. Justin Johannes Wagner. Corlia Jane Williams. Zonke Koki. National Diploma Internal Auditing. Miriam Zodwa Adonis. Gillian Arendse. Sipukazi Bakadela. Swayita Balisu. Yin Bezuidnout. Kanya Sitivayu. Noxkolo Alicia Dada. Robin Ashley DeVos. Zwelenzima Glebusuku. Unam Lisani. Felishwa Longwane. Yamkela Yusiba. Tukukwa Valerie Ekebgu. Elaine Marguerite Farmer. Nobubele Fata. Zenunisa Fisher. Mm-hmm. Liabona Gadu. Kuleka Kaza. Desideria Grashu. Madeline Monique Grigo. Kumisa Garisha. Chandra Lucinda Hin. Agnes Siasanda Lahleni. Tlontlala Jack. Asanda Nicholas Jacob. Ricardo Jacobs. Tulani Javu. Simtandile Yolanda July. Kamfa Avakili Juta. Onesimu Kayisi. Melinda Kanyane. Nomtandazu Kupeso. Sinutanda Konlo. Saneli Siwe Funeka Kupeshe. Sipu Ritabele Kulu. Zukishwa Cecilia Lam, cum laude. Zimasa Langa. Mona Lisa Luke. Sizwe Nkatazu Makanda, cum laude. Sandi Siwe Celia Makebe. Ntunduzelu Malima. Zamagaga Mampofu. Tandisile Mamfe. Lindelwa Annalisa Mani. Romeo Apewe Mankindi. Vulindelwa Markwanka. Viwe Amanda Mashalaba. Nandipa Masumpa. Nomapelo Mayeya. Fanelu Mdudu. Sisu Bisisu Mekana. Wazi Metu. Sinalu Ngwijima. Yunela Mlaba. Christia Abigail Minata. Annalisa Mkutukana. Wazi Landise Ndela. Belisa Mgwekeza. Alishin Lesha Moose. Nasipi Wendy Mpozwa. Nandipa Mpini. Tuzama Faith Mushukwana. Nokutula Ntalu. Lita Teza. Rumbitsai Primrose Mushori. Tandiwe Mindeki. Numandla Zondi. Yonela Zondi. Bruce Sipu Nkomo, cum laude. Glody Zinga Nkubu, cum laude. Vanda Nuludwe, cum laude. Nozuku Tokuzani, Pacific Nompuzolo. Ilunga Ureli Ntanga. Bule Ntoku. Ayanda Tandiwe Ntuyantu. Andisiwe Nsendwana. Sanele Bonishu Nchangase. Sikawa Nchevula. Kuluwa Ntsipu. Arnold Abram Peterson. Robin Andy Peterson. Tandukolo Sydney Ponty. Nokulunga Poswa. Benedito Dashindisho Kwede. Nandisiwe Schwam. Lizeka Joyce Sikwacha. Michael. Guguletu Avikili Sineke. Vareanga Sintumule. Mashudu Shitudolo. Shumani Shiangafi. Kulishwa Philadelphia Sky. Chandra Snyders. Aviwe Inga Sukrova. Lungelwa Griselda Stofili. Odwa Tayiya. Babalu Dorcas Tenei. Namla Chaka. Nolubabalu Chaka. Kumisa Chingele. Marie Therese Chionza Kapimba. Busisiwe Chula. Vuyalwa Tunzi. Prudence Tuyanda Chilana. Granville van Wyk. Wendlin Latoyu Williams. Sinisepu Quini Zukelwa. National Diploma Office Management and Technology. Rukaya Abdullah. Tristan Donwin Adonis. Alicia Nadine Ellen. Sinazu Olumu. Velmer Mark Apollos. Chadwin Bailey. Andisiwe Banisi. Nasli Bantam. Sadie Barron. Suraya Besterman. Bodine Matilda Bezidnote. Angelique Blankenberg. Patrick Lionel Buerta. Nolien Pul Bruins, cum laude. Unela Busika. Samantha Dawn Carolison. Aiden Charlton Carolus, cum laude. Amalia Suzelle Carstens. Janaid Chippy. Karen Caitlin Klassen. Chandra Leslie Ann Conradi. My niece, Madeleine Cronier. Siabongo Dike. Jason Lee Dirks. Christine Dornbrack. Andisiwe Diante. Pumela Diante. Wait for it. Rolene Figuera. Cum laude. Gilroy Valdu Francis. Zwandili Gandu. Olona Ginigazi. Nosipiwu Sylvia Giyama. Bakama Namla Godfrey. Tandukazi Hilesi. Aliyah Hendricks. Urina Lucinda Hendricks. Lami Livona Hendricks. Faslin Sakali Jack. Namla Ruth Kamana. Lutandu Kanzi. Nombulelu Kumalu. Tamblin Kelby Klassen. Carlin Dean Kester. Lorraise Ray Ann Klein. Abbas Mavail Kuyedama. Chantel Leroux. Sibusisu Lobby. Octavia Audrey Losper. Akona Makiko. Sidwell of Uyeli McKenzie. Zureida Magerman cum laude. Kiniui Makeng. Kuli Makosi. Anati Makatra. Sorry about that. Ondela Mandungana. Zukishwa Mankola. Atenkosi Edward Mapotolo. Bashira Marae, cum laude. Karen Murray. Sile Helen Maseko. Princess Nuluvu Maseti. Lutandu Machona. Luisa Horatius Machutiana. Sinazu Mbekwa. Choyita Mbobo. Milali Ndikazi. Lee Meisenheimer. Ntabiseng Gloria Mfuniselwa. Amanda Mjeza. Nompumelelu Lonyeni. Sizwe Ngunkeni. Ntompi Zodwa Patricia Nwana. Tukosa Simanga. Babelwa Florence Mchelelwa. Lungishwa Nzandu. Budizu Trinity Nechukochoku. Suiwe Nkaka. Kwakamba Yolanda Njosela. Zemkita Nkumanda. Wandu Nombevu. Lokutandu Nkwekuza. Nondumisu Ntanga. Noluyolo Lusha Ntanta. Babelwa Ntlati. Apiwe Nianda. Mariette Chrislyn Olin. Justin Edwell Pierce. Ada Elizabeth Peterson. Liesel Santel Plaikis. Sibongile Kweke. Patricia Recibi Rashun. Rochelle Edwina Rhodes. Luther John Benedict Roy. Sharnay Joanne Sampson. Nua Samsudin. Victoria Ruth Saunders. Melissa September. Niku John Shah. Tumelu Shokwa. Aneli Unate Sindeli. Zetu Sipoka. Zeneli Skepe. Zunaid Smith. Tulakele Sukumani. Janelle Beatrice Stoffels. Sunay Swanepoel. Sinisepu Tetana. She's a former SRC member. Celeste Gail Titus Cum Laude. Dombensiba Toti. Sedishwa Tukela. Zukishwa Mabel Teopu. Amelia van der Westhuizen, cum laude. Ziandri van Tonder. Sunay Chanel Chantel van Wyk. Tashrin Elzeth van Wyk. Crystal Joy Waits. Judy Woodman. Sinati Zeleko, Ciselo, my apology. Wayne Birkus. National Diploma Real Estate, Ivan Carstens. Dimpo Sophia Schwenimang. Michelle Christine Grail. Lurando Crawford. Zulishwa Sharon Deliwe. Nomalizu Thelma Dondolo. Dudley Engelbrecht. Tembakazi Quirana. Janine Eva Grobler. Gregory Edward Gross, cum laude. Zimkulach Gideon Hobongwana. Lulu Nondumisu Yali. Sylvia Jason. Mbanja Kaurongo. Nicholas Niku Kaoti. Alexandra Ruth Lisa King, cum laude. Valiti Patience Malope. Jeffrey Manjabadi. Tumaleng Bethuel Mashuni, cum laude. Lauren Selu Matlala. Tenja Philip Nkube. Damien Moodley. Viwe Mtisi. Mandla Mtongana. Rashid Mulaji. Viku Nampela. Vanda Christopher Ngutiana. Deidre Nolan, cum laude. Zimvukili Patrick Corney. Tunzi Anderson Kurana. Kylie Rademeyer. Loween Radford. Sanjeeva Reddy, cum laude. Kristen Daniel Ruder. Abdullah Salih, cum laude. Zandile Sapepa. Ihsam Zas. Yolanda Lamla Zuka. Baccalaureus Technology, Cost and Management Accounting. Daniel Abeka. Baid Abdul Miet Arbab. Shanae Arends. Taryn Lee Caesar. Vicky Bronwyn Simi. Eldon Kluter. Tandukazi Zizipu Dalasile. Sunel Chantel Daniels. Zainab Davids, cum laude. Danielle Cornelia Duplessis. Oloandu Dianti. Carmen Natasha Hoffman, cum laude. Kay Isaacs. Earl John James. Julian Francois Julis. We made it. Siviwe Ketani. Sibongile Pamela Kuzi. David Heinrich Lindewall. Hilmer John Liners. Aisha Mayit. Anlisiwe Makaleni. Anlisiwe Manyeya. Niameka Gladys Machisu. Pateka Mbana. Marte Buye Ndumbi. Zenkosi Ndemka. Wabisa Prudence Melani. Ferocious Mberere cum laude. Reason Membere. Amanda Luji. Siraj Mohammed. Ntombi Futi Princess Molefe. Matapelu Charlotte Moreng. Ayanda Primrose Ntunzi. Tom Benkose Nase. Seve Ngunze. Francis Bernadette Norquet. Kayakazi Tudora Nkumashe. Lepumlo Nteta. Nokolo Zamazidwe Nkumalo. Leandri Catherine Okuys. Dawn Devonshe Peterson. Charmaine Rabi. Polisa Precious Sichaluza. Teresa Geraldine Snyders. Marte Berangele Chusu Dombo, cum laude. Nameka Sonia Tomsana. Sherry Laverne van Rijsig. Danley John van Wyk, cum laude. Mwabu Advocate Vaveki. McGrath Witboy. Zikona Kolashe, cum laude. Baccalaureus Technology Internal Auditing. Byron Adams. Darila Antonia Sungules Agostino. Susanna Simao Antonio. Leandri April. Anne Bierkes. Delsha Kim Boysen. Jamie Lee Bruce. Nomvelo Boshwana. Roxanne Karulison. Ines Lezan Karolis. Shirley Kim Chandler. Refilwe Felicia Cho. Sharnay Christie Davids. Zanelli Dodi. Sandy Siwe Duba. Lee and Lauren Erasmus, cum laude. Anthony Gioke Izionbuka, cum laude. Nombusu Lorraine Ganta. Janine Gideon. Hilary Ann Hendricks. Marius Hermanus. Lutandu Slashaneni. Zinzi Jacobs. Natasha Lucinda Jones. Imizembe Uyangnakwu Kambo. Ernest Katyataku. Guhipa Kavara. Juliet Kayakazi Kulayana. Kulawa Pinky Kumani. Owetu Kona. Olivia Nerissa Koopman. Davir Kotsia. Zikona Kwachana. Bulelwa Lakile, sorry, Lalekile. Apiwe Madushela. Nosiviwe Mahashe. Sianda Makalima. This candidate has his birthday today. Fatuwani Chibuvumu Maliva. Michelle Rufaru Mandaza. Ntombi Kayise Catherine Matana. Ntombi Zodwa Mbeta. Boyeshwa Bukazi. Onele Kone Ngijima. Pochoko Kevin Moibi Cum Laude. Vuyuvetu Nangu. Zipuzetu Nguliwe. Kanyisi Kumeza. Zivikele Damasi. Lisa Nkwala. Sianda Ntlanaya. Nlayana. Sorry. Zemkita Ntuli. Bulelwa Nyandeni. Cindy Lee Charlene Pick. Samantha Bianca Mini Prinsloo. Sipisande Rudaber Kwebe, Kweke. Sorry. Babelwa Radebe Cum Laude. Bonukalu Atenkosi Saleni. Kanyisa Lincoln Selman. Yeah. Monica Salumi Samuel. Robin September. Buiselo Clinton Sifumba Cum Laude. Oliver Tamu Kogang. Siabonga Tuniwashe. Koliseko Timakwe. Ntombi Sisiwe Chabe. Ayanda Chefu. Graham Williams. Benati Zinzili. Belisa Zuba. Baccalaureus Technologi Office Management and Technology. Tracy Camilla Adams. Lene Kusia. Ashley Peter February. Joy Dawn Harris. Marshall Manfred Hendricks. Juanita Kazi Cum Laude. Nadia Lambrechts. Sipuvo Langa. Kim Ilse Lawrence. Seanville LaRue. Nashleen Genevieve Martin. Godfrey Matanga. Seviwe Mjordu. Nokolo Mtetu. Tatenda Muvezwa. This is my colleague, Joanne Lucinda Ritter. Jamie September. Bongani Tunzi Sibande, cum laude. Ulise John Siutewa. Henriette Steenkamp, cum laude. Annemie Stein. Ashley Taylor. Sherry Lisa Titus. Zambini Heidi Kusha. Magister Technology, Cost and Management Accounting. With a thesis title, The Usage of Management Accounting Tools by Small and Medium Enterprises in Cape Metropole, South Africa, with supervisors Dr. P. N. Kamala and Dr. Michael Twendaku, Shandina Caroline Madukwe, cum laude. Magister Technology, Cost and Management Accounting, with the title Management Accounting Skills of Decision Makers of Small, Medium and Micro Enterprises in the Tourism Industry, Western Cape, South Africa, with Supervisor Dr. Henry Benedict, Ernest Pierre Chagao Mbumbo. Magister Technology Internal Auditing. With a title Social Media Risks in Large and Medium Enterprises in the Cape Metropole, the Role of Internal Auditors, with supervisors Dr. Yolandi Smith and Dr. Suzanne Leroux, Leon Tinashe Gwaka. Ladies and gentlemen, we are going to award two Dean's medalists, medals to Dean medalists, as well as the Vice Chancellor's medal to one candidate. I'm calling upon Abdullah Sali of the National Diploma Real Estate. Abdullah was born in Cape Town in 1980 and obtained his senior certificate at Marlborough Garden Secondary School in Gauteng in 1997. In 2013, he registered for his National Diploma in Real Estate at CPUT, where he obtained 12 distinctions out of 12 subjects. Over the 3 years of study. While studying, Abdullah completed a three-year internship at the City of Cape Town and is currently working in the City of Cape Town Property Valuation Department. I'm calling upon the second medalist, Bashira Maree, National Diploma Office Management and Technology. Bashira was born in Cape Town in 1992 and obtained the National Senior Certificate at Alexander Sinton High School in 2009. In 2013, she registered for the National Diploma in Office Management and Technology at CPUT and obtained 17 distinctions out of 17 subjects. With a final aggregate of 85.176% over the 3 years of study. She's currently completing a BTEC in Office Management and Technology. I'm calling upon the receiver of the Vice Chancellor's Medal, Anthony Gioke Izunbuku, BTEC Internal Auditing.